Getting aid into Gaza immediately is both vital and complicated. There are 7 crossings around the Gaza Strip. All are controlled by Israel, except one, Rafah, which connects Gaza and Egypt. Egypt controls that crossing. But Israel bombed it on the 10th of October and again on October the 16th. Since the war began, there's been conflicted information about when or if the crossing will open, and people have been waiting. Thousands of tons of international aid for Gaza have already been pre-positioned at Egypt's Al Arish airport, 45 kilometres from Gaza. And a convoy of trucks carrying essential supplies is stalled near the border. Egypt has reinforced its side of the Rafah crossing with concrete walls. It doesn't want a repeat of 2008 when thousands of people stormed the barrier from the Gaza side. The UN says it'll only be able to distribute aid when there's a pause in the fighting, but 2 draft resolutions for a humanitarian ceasefare have failed to pass at the UN Security Council. Instead, US President Joe Biden brokered a deal with Egypt to open the crossing for aid, and he extracted a promise from Israel not to bomb it. Meanwhile, the UN Secretary General Antonio Guterres is in Egypt, where he hopes personally to oversee the delivery to Gaza. The UN says its supplies include food for 250,000 Palestinians for a week, medicine for 300,000 people and trauma kits. But Biden's deal only allows 20 truckloads into Gaza, a fraction of what's needed. Before the war, the UN said about 100 trucks would deliver humanitarian aid to Gaza every single day. And it's not clear where the fuel will come from to deliver these desperately needed items to all corners of the Gaza Strip.